Everyone, welcome back to the channel.
I have a surprise today. It's a full house.
So we have Maddie.
Yes.
And we have Truth.
Yes.
Hello.
How are you, Maddie? Tell us.
I'm very good.
What's been up with you?
Yes, you can see there's a new background, which means I have been kicked out of my old apartment. I found a new apartment. I'm living out of boxes. But it's good to be back. It's
so bad, Maddie. How much are you partying that you've been kicked out of your houses and all? Now you need to shift houses?
But good, congratulations on the new apartment and housewarming होगी तब हम आएंगे. And
अभी तो सब कुछ virtual हो रहा है, so
I know that we'll do a separate wine and cheese session for your housewarming. Yes. But now we are here for something special, equally special, and that is farewell. And sort of mini little tribute that we wanted to do for Strings, because the sad announcement hit all of us recently that they've disbanded after some 33 years. And I don't know if people were expecting it. We certainly weren't. So when I saw that on Instagram and I sent it to Maddie and Shruti, all of us were sending each other the crying emojis.
Crying emojis. I think the crying emoji and the heartbreak emoji was what I saw. Because immediately, you know, I sent it to all my friends, all of us who grew up listening to Strings. And immediately it was the same, you know, sad emoji. Like, or what? I saw people posting or reposting their post of announcing that they've decided to call it quits with a heartbreak, you know. Yeah. So that's what I kept seeing the entire day. And I was just like, I would have never guessed that the two of them would say, okay, we want to hang up our gloves soon.
I know.
I would have never expected the two of them, right?
And I don't get it. Why would they do that? Because chal raha hai na, theek hai, agar album release nahi bhi kar rahe, live shows ho rahe, sab kuch ho rahe, chal rahi hai life. Why did they have to do that?
You know, they were even...
sab kuch chal raha tha.
I know, but I mean, everyone has their reasons. We respect their decisions. Yeah, I mean, everyone has different chapters in their life they need to get to and open.
So. Yes.
Theek hai. But Maddie's happily joined us because she loves Strings, and we are now...
Strings, yes.
Yeah, so I did a poll, and don't blame me if this was not your choice, but I did a poll on my Instagram, which is why I keep telling you, you know, go there. And I asked people if we did a Strings tribute and farewell reaction, then which song should we react to? And this was the most highly requested one, which is Mera Bichla Yaar from the Red Bull Music Sound Clash. So, it's the live version.
Okay. I like
what we are getting to first.
Hena? We like.
Okay. Yeah,
I heard the original. I've not seen the live version, but like the original, I love.
Yeah.
I don't think aisa koi gaana hai jo humne nahi suna hai. I think hum sabne suna
hoga. That is true.
This is an all-time favorite from Strings. And Maddie, you and I reacted to Dur from the Music Sound Clash. And you remember how happy it was.
Correct.
Joy. So, I think it's an entire concert.
Yes, I think this set of videos, it won't be a reaction video, it'll become a lip sync video because we will be singing throughout. Because the last time that's what happened when we were watching them doing the Na Jaane Kyun with Mera Bichla, which is a medley that they did. When they started singing Mera Bichla Yaar, Joe and I were just happily humming throughout. And we had to tell ourselves, you know, don't do it silently. The mic will pick up the audio. We had to tell ourselves that. So this will be pretty much the same thing, I think, these two videos as well. So
We will not subject people to our shower singing capabilities. Yes. Let's just get into it. Are we ready?
Yes.
Yes, we are.
Okay, chalo. 1, 2, 3, play.
Round number 3. The Clash.
And
दूर एक गांव में
I mean, of course.
They're playing with the audience.
Yeah.
Okay, now this time you guys can sing a little more, okay? Mil gaya wo.
Shall we sing?
Jo chura ke.
बहती नदियां हैं,
नाला है नदियां।
बहती नदियां है कर मेरा इंतजार छड़ाया कर मेरा इंतजार मेरा बिछड़ाया मेरा बिछड़ाया.
थैंक यू.
रेड बुल म्यूजिक. यार ये कितना पुराना वीडियो है. इट लिटरली सीम्स लाइक दे न्यू के ये ना लाइक इट्स अ ट्रिब्यूट काइंड ऑफ अ थिंग. परफॉर्मेंस भी वैसी थी. व्हाट इज दिस? व्हाट इज दिस?
द फीलिंग वाज डिफरेंट ना. नाउ वाचिंग इट एट दिस पॉइंट आफ्टर दे अनाउंस्ड.
Actually, after they announced and I was listening, I was getting goosebumps. When they first started, when he first started the couple of lines, I was getting goosebumps. And you know, while I was watching them, I was kicking myself for not actually catching them live in concert where I had an opportunity to, because now I don't know if they will perform. No, I haven't. I did. I think something happened. I couldn't catch them when they performed in Dubai. I couldn't.
Yeah.
So now I feel like chance was over.
I was getting emotional towards the second part when he came back. Just because now that we know they're not going to... I was still... And when it started and the keys were playing, I was like, you know, I wish they would do a final live gig, like just as a goodbye gig for the fans.
All over the world. Everywhere.
Yes, all over the world. Yes, they need to do a world tour.
Yes. They should do that. And even if they don't and they just do it in like one city or one big event, people will fly in from around the world for it, right? Yes. They're just big a name and they've left that much of an impression in people's lives. I mean...
I was saying that listening to it, you know, how always that happens. Songs remind you of different phases of your life.
Yes,
this was radio for me. Strings was radio for me. That's how and when I, you know, it started for me through my career, early days. It's for same for all of us, I think. All three of us.
Yeah.
Correct.
And with every song of theirs, it was like a different milestone. You know, it's something that's been there constantly in your life. You don't expect it to go away. It's something to take for granted. Saying, ye to hai hi na. Matlab ye kahan jayenge? It's like one of those feelings. So when I was listening to the song and I was literally going back in my mind saying, this was the moment I heard it first. This was the moment I played it on my show. These are the milestones that happened with me, with this song, or that trip that I took when I heard this song. And I was just going through all that. To me, I wasn't saying bye to them. For me, it was also like, literally, I'm saying bye to that life of mine, which is
gone. Your own moments.
I was getting there in that moment. I was feeling very like, I don't want to go old. I don't want to say bye to strings. I don't want it to go.
Yeah, I know. I can completely relate to that because Joe had given me a heads up and obviously, you know, like the prep starts happening in your mind, right? So I was like, okay.
Going back.
And I woke up with this morning, I think I was listening to all of them. I just had the strings playlist on in the morning and I was just listening and I had the same reaction. I was like, when I was listening to each one of the songs, you're reminded of a particular phase in your life. And recently something happened where it also marked like an end of my knowing somebody. And I've known this person for a very long time. And it also felt like, okay, you know, this seems like a goodbye to that phase of your life.
Yeah.
And,
yeah.
you know, also goodbye in a way to those people. Because then you also realize that you've grown, others have grown, and you've probably also grown apart, right? So it's just... because of what's happening and why we are listening to strings, I think it's also been a very like introspective time for each one of us in a very different way, I suppose, right?
Yep, absolutely. Yeah. So I don't know, but I think is wale gaane mein, is performance mein, I really miss Faisal on the vocals, no? Yeah.
Yes.
We have to hear Faisal doing his thing as well. So there's another request that was, I think, second in the list. Zinda from the Battle of the Bands. They sang it live on stage. Okay. So I think we're getting the best of all the TV shows.
Yes.
Let's watch Zinda and then we'll get into all our strings memories. What's it?
Yes. Done. Done. Yep. Okay. Sounds good.
Done.
Chalo, let's start. 1, 2, 3, play. Ooh. There he is.
Thank you.
खामोश जिंदगानी सन्नाटा कह रहा है क्यों सुर सह रहा है एक दास्ता पुरानी तन्हाई की हर सख्त खिल रहा है कुछ मुझसे कह रहा है चुपते काटे यादों के दामन से चुनता हूँ गिरते दीवारों के चल में जिंदा हूं बस ये मेरी कहानी बेनिशान निशानी एक दर बह रहा है कुछ मुझसे कह रहा है छुपते काटे यादों के दामन से चुनता हूँ गिरती दीवारों के आंचल में जिंदा हूँ बजाए प्यार की शबनम मेरे गुलिस्तां में बरसते रहते हैं हर सिमत मौत के साए स्याहियों से उलझ पड़ती हैं मेरी आंखें कोई नहीं है कोई भी नहीं जो बतलाए मैं कितनी देर उजालों की राह देखूंगा कोई नहीं है कोई भी नहीं ना पास ना दूर एक यार है दिल की धड़कन अपनी चाहत का जो ऐलान किए जाती है जिंदगी है जो जिए जाती है खून के घूंट पिए जाती है ख्वाब कांटों से सिए जाती है
Digging the guitar riff on this version.
Oh.
दामन से चुनता हूँ, गिरती दीवारों के आंचल में जिंदा हूँ।
That's a finish.
Oh my God.
Wow.
That just made me very happy. Because, yes. And it was like, all of them were having so much fun. It was fun watching them. You know, exactly. When a group of musicians, they're just doing their thing and they're having fun. And this was just pure joy. It was just bliss.
In the zone. They were all in the zone. And oh my God. Oh, so happy. That was, I think, we must give props to every single band member at this point, because, you know, Faisal and Bilal for sure, but Ahad on the drums, there's Heather Ali keyboards, Adil Ali keyboards, Bradley D'Souza, former member Shakir Khan, Kesar, Rafiq Wazir Ali, and Kareem Bashir. I think all of them over the years, however long they've been in and out of the band.
Yes.
Just amazing.
That's so much style, man. They had like their moments in the when they were singing all the it was just this performance.
This is
This one is for the books. Yeah. This one is for the books. This one is definitely for the books. One for the books.
They're the original guys.
Yeah, they're the OGs. And the thing is, they're just bringing out the best in each other when they're playing around like this on stage. Mm-hmm. I think Maddie, it happened in Dur when we watched that for the first time. That was a live performance that I haven't seen many live performances or had seen before that one. Even though I've watched them live, luckily a couple of times in Dubai, but I don't think it was these band members when I got them live.
Okay.
So it was a different energy and the setting was different. I think one of the concerts was when Strings played before Rahat Fateh Ali Khan Saab took over the rest of the evening. So it was kind of a mix of different sounds. I think they also kept it a little mellow in that concert that I was at. So anyway, this one, Zinda, even when they were singing that the lyrics, Chupte Kaate Yaado Ke, I was like, oh, now every time you listen to Strings, Chupenge Kaate Yaado Ke. Because... Let's just go into our personal memories. So my first intro to Strings was Dur. I heard it in college. And then very soon after, when I got into radio, was when I got introduced to the rest of their repertoire. And then we played so much of them. We had so many concerts of theirs that we were radio partners for. Then they, you know, interviewed them. They were in our studios a lot. It's just been exactly what Shruti said earlier. It's so many different phases of your life that come back at you through their music. Right?
Mine has to be Dur, but I remember very vividly, and I mean Shruti would remember this, right? MTV Select with Nikhil Chinappa every day between 3 and 4 p.m. and was my gateway to discover a lot of music. And if there was there was a track that Nikhil sold it, then it was like he sold it. I mean, he was like the original influencer, right? In those
days. So I remember watching it and said it was
exactly there were songs because Nikhil sold it as this is a brand new track, and I absolutely loved it. Obviously, later when you get into the business, you realize that every song you absolutely love it because you're selling it. But we used to wait, and because people used to request.
He genuinely meant it.
He meant it.
For sure.
So Dur was the first song, and I remember also now. Obviously, I have to go back and see the video again. It was these two guys, and I remember Dur was just the two of them playing guitar, and I think Bilal is wearing a white shirt or a light blue shirt with his jeans, and he's playing guitar, and it looks like somewhere which is like dry and there is wind blowing and dust and all of that, right? That was the video. And then that is really aging me, but that was my introduction to but that was also the time when we had Junoon, you had Strings, you had the boys, and then you had Viva, and you had all of the, there was a lot of great indie pop coming from either sides of the border. So the subcontinent was putting out a lot of non-film music.
Yeah.
So that's how I remember being introduced to Strings. Strings, was, Junoon was all the same high school, early college.
So this song, 20s. Zinda, you're saying about non-film music, right? Zinda came out as Sanjay Dutt's film. And yes. this song was specifically, you know, the moment we heard it, we were like, all right, wow, strings are singing for a film now.
Yes.
Oh.
Yes.
Crazy to rapper.
Yes. They started touring the country in all these Channel V gigs and all the concerts were happening around. Yeah. I think Junoon also, Strings also, they were all coming and traveling around the country very often. And I think that's the thing, because the TV channels made them so big across the border. It was just very easy. You know, for the fan base to just keep growing and growing and not look back. And then the whole, you know, them entering Bollywood and Zinda was there. There was another song, no?
They did Na Jaane Kyun for the Spider-Man soundtrack.
Which was original album.
That was from their album. Yeah. That was part of the Spider-Man OST. And then this, but this one I remember because somehow the part, right, the spoken word bit. And in the video, you remember the Sanjay Dutt and John Abraham take turns reading out those lines. Yeah. But Faisal's voice just suited Sanjay Dutt so well. I remember that song was a earworm for many days when that song first came out, Ye Hai Meri Kahani. And I have very specific memories of having a Sony Walkman W810 iPhone where I would load my music on that. This is before iPods and smartphones and all of it. And I would go in the morning, I'd go for my recording sessions, for my VO sessions. And this song used to always be on the playlist that I would listen to while I would be sitting in my auto going from one end of Bangalore to the other end to finish my recording session at 8 in the morning. So this song has a very specific 2005, 2006 memory for me.
This was the most requested track in radio when I first got in the industry. It was just everyone wanted it. And one of the earliest, I think the first concert of theirs I was at live, it was the crowd was going nuts for this song, for Zinda. Mm-hmm. I think it also worked on making the movie even more popular than it would have been.
Completely. Like my introduction, Sar Ki Hai Ye Pahar. So when that song, and I heard it first in radio, like because I joined radio and college mein maine nahi suna tha. Radio mein aate hi, that was the first song I heard and I was like, what is this voice? Who are these people? What am I listening to? What is going on?
Yeah.
Complete crazy happened. And then of course, Dur happened. And so I heard these songs together. But Sar Ki Hai Ye Pahar, I was stuck to it. I was stuck to it for days and days together. And then I got a chance to interview them. I freaked out. I was like, what is going to happen? How am I going to miss them? So I never ever have had a fangirl moment with anybody except these two, Bilal and Faisal. And I was like, how am I going to talk to them? So during the link, I'm very composed and controlled. And I had one very beautiful, like, you know, nice link discussion. And the moment the mics would go off, I was like, I'm a crazy fan of yours. I love you guys. I love your music. They were like, how are you switching? Ye tum kaise kar rahe ho? Ke tum, like, you know, you're like being all like sane in this case. And then like suddenly going crazy. I was like, what to do? That's the effect you have on me. And then they started singing. That was over. The moment I started singing, I was like, I cannot contain it now. I will just like melt. So that was a
live interview in the studio, right? I was going to say, or was it one of those Telos lines, which was crazy to set up and you never had control over the quality
This was live.
If it was live, then I don't know how you controlled your fangirl.
Exactly.
On the mic.
You have no idea.
Well done.
Before that, my boss had come in and said, you'll be fine, no? Matlab, you're not going to freak out and suddenly go like fangirl crazy on them. I said, no, I will be like, don't worry.
Nice.
Well done. You should go and dig out that interview now.
You should find it. What archives? I know. I should today there are like full like your broadcasting from the studio. Back then that never used to happen. It was all about you're being in the moment, you're keeping it live, and that's it. Like, you know, then it's in your memory. It's over.
Correct. If you had the foresight to ask somebody to bring a camera or book a photographer, you would get the pictures a couple of days later. These are the times, right? You had to organize it. Unlike now where you're just doing a live session while somebody is coming into the studio, you're tweeting, you're like posting all of that. I remember those days you had to ask for the photographer and there would be one standard photographer who would come for all of these meet and greets and take pictures, and then you would get it like a day later or 2 days later, something like that.
We're sounding like fossils, but you know, we started in 2008-09, you know, the whole photography video taking bit, but this is before that, guys. But we are not fossils.
We all started 4 or 5. I started 2004.
So 2002. Straight out of college.
I was 10 years old when I started, just saying.
So funny. Strings were -5 back then.
No, but I can't believe you know, the one song of theirs that I used to love playing on air, and I know Maddie, your favorite is Tithiya, which is very underrated.
Yes.
Mine was Chai
Yes.
Chai. Anytime I needed to go into a good mood, I would just put on Chai Chai on radio when I know I'm going to be in my car. So the pop, I would be like, okay, I'm going to be driving between 6 and 6:30 p.m. So I'll put all my favorite songs in
Yes.
the playlist.
That I have to say is one of those perks of being on radio that, you know, I mean, it's a luxury. I mean, of course, now you have your Spotify's and all of it, but the joy of being able to program your music according to your commute, because you want to listen to that song, is priceless. I don't think it's a Visa ad, right? Cost of a premium membership so much, unlimited songs so much, but the joy of playing your song when you want on radio is truly priceless.
And God forbid if somebody shuffles it and changed it. Arey, but ye gana kab laga tha? How did it not play?
Oh, I used to lose my if someone shuffled or changed the order, I would just be calling the studio like, why? Who asked you?
I mean, there was a brief period before. I mean, I was on air for a couple of years, and then I became a music manager. So it used to be the same thing, right? I would know when the jocks would shuffle music. So they just expected me to land in the studio 2 minutes or 30 seconds after they shuffled a song, saying, "Why did the song move?" You know, they just expected. They were like one of
three,
our jocks.
Two, one, open.
Yes. Like I've actually had one of our jocks that Joe knows, Danny, and he would change a song. And when I would walk into the studio, he's like, "There, I told you." She would walk in. "I'm sorry, I was just adjusting for time." And he would have a valid explanation, but it was like, "Why did you move that song?" So
good
yeah.
fun day. See, listening to strings is taking us back to so many memories. You know,
I'm just going to pretend that this hasn't happened, and I will go back and listen to their first album, then second and third. I will just listen, revisit.
And this is not going to be the last Strings Reaction also on the channel. We'll keep reacting
of
to
course.
Other songs of theirs that we haven't seen yet or haven't watched, because they had new releases recently. They had
an album
and some singles come out.
Yes.
And of course, there's a lot of the folk studio songs in the seasons that they produced that we haven't checked out. So all that will continue, guys. Don't panic. And I think we should just thank Bilal and Faisal and the gang for all the memories.
All the music. And
all
the
music.
Yes.
And we hope
you guys.
There's still scope for a world tour, a farewell tour. And I hope they do
Yes. Yes.
You know?
Please to do it.
Post-pandemic.
Please to do it.
Thank you guys for watching and for requesting this farewell and this tribute and this reaction.
This was fun.
Thank you, Maddie, for coming back.
This
was
fun. Of course, I had to come back for strings. This was fun. Yeah, hopefully, I'll be able to do this more often. Hopefully.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yay.
Yes, go ahead.
Lovely. On that note, guys, we'll see you in the next one. Live long and prosper.
Bye.